saved everyone in the universe and I became a hero. Welcome back to Good Morning Sri Lanka. In case you just tuned in, we have a motivational speaker in the studio. We have Sanjeev Jayaratnam here. And he was just speaking about positive vibes, your thoughts,
setting goals, going towards achieving
and
them.
And achieving them. Mm-hmm. That is true. But right now we're getting to something else that you have started, which is called speed reading.
That's right.
Okay. Tell us about how this started out, Sanjeev.
Yeah. Okay, see, it started off for very selfish reasons.
Okay.
Yeah, because I wanted to read faster.
That's logical. Now you want to read.
But actually, yes. Yeah, because I was doing my MBA at the time, and mm-hmm. there's tons to read. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I came across this concept on the internet.
Right.
And I did some self-studying mm-hmm. and learned the concepts, and then found that wow, it's really useful.
Yeah.
But of course, I never taught anybody about it for another 10 years after that.
Oh, okay, okay.
Maybe not 10, 7.
Somewhere around.
Yeah, somewhere there, right? And then what happened was I was talking to a friend of mine about this thing called speed reading. And he said, can you teach my stuff? Right. And this guy had a small consulting company.
Okay.
Yeah? So I did. And mm-hmm. it went well. Yeah?
Okay.
And then he gave me the idea, right? Okay, nobody else is doing this. Why don't you do it? And there's a huge market for it.
Mm-hmm.
And so we did.
Yeah.
And so many years down the road, we have actually had a lot of success. We have taught over 1,300 people mm-hmm. To speed read. And this is from top corporate executives. Like we have taught Dr. Gamini Vikramasinghe, who was the previous chairman of Bank of Ceylon. Mm-hmm. Yeah, lots of top people at right. MS, Bandix.
They all learned right
down,
to
yeah, right down
double
to
their
kids.
Reading speed.
Actually, right down to kids of about 8 years old.
Oh,
right?
Wow.
So you can, as long as you can read, you can speed read.
Right.
And yes, what we promise is that you're going to be able to increase your reading productivity by a minimum of 100%.
Okay.
Right? But what the results have been actually so much better than that. On average, people have ended up reading 8 times faster than they were doing before.
8 times faster?
Yeah.
Wow.
And it's not only the
That's
reading
crazy.
Speed. It is your reading 8 times faster, actually understanding and retaining much more than you did before.
Right. Yeah.
And it's very simple, really, if you think about it.
So how long does this take? I mean, it must be like a long process.
Well, not really. It's like any skill.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we can sometimes learn to swim in a week
right.
if you go for classes every day of the week, right?
That's true.
That's true. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, and you practice.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
right. So this particular program is just a 12-hour program, but spaced out over 3 weeks.
I see. Okay.
So it's 4 hours per week for mm-hmm. 3 weeks, and you're there.
Yeah.
So let me get this straight. If you dedicate 12 hours hmm. from your time hmm. to learning speed reading,
yeah.
then you can guarantee that I can increase my reading speed at least 100%.
Definitely. Definitely.
Wow. And what are the definitely. Benefits of this? I mean, once you learn to speed read.
See, it's not just that you can read faster, because some people say, right, come on, I don't want to read fast. I'm quite happy reading mm-hmm. the way I am.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But let me ask you guys, do you find that when you're reading some document, you're trying to read it, but your mind is elsewhere? Does that happen?
Yes. That is true.
Jason, it does, right?
Oh,
it
my is. Mind tends to trail off
too.
From time to time. So,
you're not alone, because it happens to everyone.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
And the reason is that our mind gets bored pretty fast.
Yeah. I see.
So what happens with speed reading is, because we are reading faster, your focus is increased.
I see. Okay.
Because your focus has increased, you are actually able to absorb that much more.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's like when you're driving really fast, you're driving at 120 kilometers per hour, you're not going to be looking around, right? You're totally focused on what you're doing, because
true.
A split second mistake and you're dead.
Yeah.
Right?
So that's one way to put it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
But so what happens is, it's just that the speed mm-hmm. increases your focus.
Right.
And with your focus increased, you're actually able to retain and absorb much more.
Right.
And the thing is, it's all done in a mind-friendly way.
Okay.
So you don't have a nervous breakdown somewhere in the middle of the program.
See, our mind actually wants to do it this way. That is why we get bored and we start thinking of other things.
Yeah. Okay.
Because our mind is actually capable of so much more than we give it credit for.
Mm, mm, mm,
yeah.
Mm.
So it's the way we normally read is very unnatural. Really.
Right. Okay.
Oh, I see.
So it has to be full on focus
yeah.
and you start reading. So
yeah.
this is actually quite the great bargain here, that you could actually put this out in
yeah, it is, Jason. I'm really interested in this, but maybe you could give us some tips now, like a crash course on speed reading on Good Morning Sri Lanka.
Only here on Good Morning Sri Lanka, we give you quick tips.
I think you're also asking how it benefits someone, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. See, how does it benefit a student? Sometimes we are stuck for time, right? I'm able to revise my subject, let's say, I don't know, science or history or something, mm-hmm. just once before the exam. Mm-hmm. Yeah? See, with speed reading, you can revise it maybe 3 times, 4 times.
Wow.
Yeah. In the time it would have earlier taken you to revise once. And the thing with our mind is, the more times the same thing gets into our mind, the same information mm-hmm. gets into our mind, the more times it gets in, it's going to stay longer.
Right.
And that's the only way to move something from short-term memory to long-term memory. Mm-hmm. A simple example is, think of all the names of the employees of MTV that you know.
Okay.
Yeah. And then think back to see, okay, did you ever go back and write the names down and memorize them?
No.
No. How did we get to know them? Just by usage,
isn't
it?
Them? Right. Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's true.
You never knew them on the first day.
No.
It may have taken a week, 2 weeks.
But like, it's hey, you, how are you?
Yeah. And now because I've used you guys' names a couple of times in the program, I'm not going to forget it.
Of course.
Yeah. Usage.
Right. I could become like Jason Bourne, man.
I had a friend who used to study, and her method was, she'd read the book, just read it, not even memorize it, read it 21 times.
Yeah.
And then she's done. Yeah. She studied. Yeah. She knows everything in the book.
Yeah.
She doesn't try to memorize it, just read it through.
See, we can't actually try to remember things. We either will remember it or not. We also can't try to understand things. Think about it, right?
Yeah.
If we don't have a grounding in a particular subject, however many times we read it, we can't understand.
Yeah.
So, but if you repeat it, once you understand, of course, the more times you repeat, it's going to stay. And that's the way to remember. That's what we call revision, isn't it?
So give us a few tips, just a few tips.
Simple. So you take a pacer. Can I borrow that piece of paper?
Here you go.
And your pencil also.
And my pencil.
And your pencil.
The trusty MTV pencil.
So this is all you do. You take a pencil, something we call a pacer. It could be a toothpick, a chopstick, something.
Okay.
Something thin and long.
Pointy.
Pointy. And you just do things like that. So it's an underline in motion.
Mm-hmm.
And it's movement. So when the pacer moves, your eyes follow the movement.
Okay.
And when your eyes follow the movement, your eyes remain focused.
Wow, that actually does make sense.
So
that's how you should read.
Yeah, there's your good morning tip.
Wow, okay. I'm honestly going to try that. Read a page the way I usually read it.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to use Sanjeev's method and time it out and see how it
now
goes.
Now, since Sanjeev has given me this tip, it opens up a whole new gateway of what I think of the human race. We could be distracted easily by dangling something in front of our faces. Would you agree? I mean, like, for example, you just said, we would stare at the movement that our hand is moving with the pen.
Yeah.
So that explains a lot when it comes to evolution of humanity. Like, we were so dumb, but now we're smarter. Do you get it? Oh my God, it's all connected, bro. No, I'm being a hippie right now, but it actually makes sense though. Like, we actually do develop our skills and in time, we could actually reach what we want. And that, again, linking to your motivational thinking.
It's all connected, man. Jason is just having like
a revelation.
A revelation. Everything is falling into place.
Yeah, everything is.
Speaking about revelations, have you taught all the boys in Revelations as well how they can?
A couple of them.
Okay. A few of them, but you teach them other things. Now you have the Revelations Academy.
That's right, which has come up.
And how is that going so
That's
far?
Going great. That's going great.
Mm-hmm.
We recently sent some kids for the Royal Schools of Music exam, and they almost all of them got distinction. So that was we were really pleased about that.
Mm-hmm.
Also because it was the first time we sent kids for an exam.
So you prepped them and sent them off. But it's just singing so far, is it?
No, it's singing. It's drama, it's art, it's guitar, and it's drums.
Okay. So who else do you have working with you on all of these things? Let's give them a shout out as well.
Yeah, lots of guys. We have Ray Gomez who teaches the guitar.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then we have a couple of guys, Senaka Pereira of Anno Domini Edi.
Okay.
Who does the drums.
Right.
And then me, and there's another guy from the Revelations, a guy called Asanka who teaches singing, together with some other ladies as well, Dilini, Rebecca, various people.
Right.
Okay. A good team.
Group collaboration, and that's a great source.
My brother teaches drama.
I see.
Yeah.
That is exciting. Sanjeev, unfortunately, we are out of time.
Yeah, it's been lovely.
But you have picked up people who were summing it you can pick them up, lift up their spirits in this.
Mm-hmm. And at least you've taught two people more in Sri Lanka how to do speed reading and how to set goals.
Well, that's just the bare minimum. Come for the program.
Definitely. There if you want to find out more information about Sanjeev's courses, you can visit them on www.revpe.com. That's R-E-V-P-E.com. More information. Also, you can email us at mtvsports@maharaja.lk. You can email us and we'll get you any more information you'd like to know about Sanjeev. Again, such a pleasure having you on
the
show.
Thank you so much, Jason.
All right, so we'll be right back after this break with more cupcakes, I think.
Cookies.
I'm sorry. Yeah. Cookies, cupcakes. It's all treats. We'll be right back after this commercial break.